In the 1950s, the federal government instituted yet another new Indian policy known as termination. The purpose of this policy? To eliminate tribal governments and tribal lands, along with any vestige of tribal identity, so that the Red Nation would become part of America's great melting pot. A major part of this program launched another relocation campaign which offered training, jobs, and a part of the American dream to any Indian who would leave the reservation and move to the city. What most Indians who signed up for the relocation program found instead was isolation, alienation, and further disintegration of their culture and identity. And so this policy became one more chapter of the American Holocaust.
Disrespectful to us, it's disrespectful to our ancestors, and so, you know, teaching is a better way than to go out and to, you know, scream out in the public or, mm-hmm. you know, stomp your fist or clench your fist yeah. and throw it in the air and mm-hmm. and say, you know, you disrespected these Native people, because nobody's learning anything from that. Mm-hmm.
After the War of 1812, over 300 African-American men and their families occupied an abandoned British fort on the banks of the Apalachicola River, or what is now Florida. Known as Negro Fort, it was headed by an African-American man named, only known as Gaston. The heavily armed fort became a symbol of black independence and a threat to the Southern slave system. The United States government made destruction of the fort one of its highest priorities after the War of 1812. In the summer of 1816, the U.S. Navy and Army under Colonel Clinch surrounded Negro Fort and called on the community to surrender. Gaston refused. On July 27, 1816, an attack was launched by the combined forces of the American Army and their Creek Indian allies, but the heavily fortified garrison repelled it from the combined strength of the African-American troops and their Choctaw Indian allies. But a second attack succeeded in hitting the ammunition supply, and the fort exploded. Only 64 of the 300 African-American men survived the blast, and only 3 of the 64 were uninjured. Gaston, unhurt, was executed by a firing squad, and his Choctaw Indian ally chief was scalped by the Creeks. The remaining survivors were all returned to slavery.
I will never understand why people come on a public platform and blatantly lie in the faces of our people. It is clear that the Europeans, as well as the Arabs, are in fact partnered up strategically in the enslavement of our people in North Africa, Libya, Tunisia, Morocco. We know because we have heard their voices. They have spoken up. They have come forward. There is evidence. There are videos. There's everything we need to know to believe the lived experiences of our people. This is a continuation of the very same Arab slave trade that began a very long time ago when they infiltrated North Africa. This is so inconsiderate of people. So disgusting. To want to reconstruct history so that it fits your narrative. It is wrong. This is the same enslavement that our people have been going through for many, many years since the infiltration of our continent. Don't silence us. Do not tone police us. Do not tell us how to tell our story. This is all of y'all against us. It's us against the world.